Hello, welcome back to my channel. I am Nisha Jain. I'm standing inside of one of the historic buildings in the city of London. This company is called Worshipful Company of Ironmongers. It is one of the great 12 livery companies in the city of London. I'm gonna go and talk to Colonel Charlie Nag. He's the clerk of Ironmongers, and he has agreed to give us a tour of the hall, and he's gonna talk us about the history of the company. Let's go and meet him.
A very warm welcome to the Ironmongers Hall. I'm Charlie Knights. I'm the clerk and the chief executive of the Worshipful Company of Ironmongers. The Ironmongers Company, one of the great 12 livery companies, was formed in 1463 by royal charter from King Edward IV.
The Ironmongers' history starts well over 600 years ago. It began as a trade organisation for those people who sold iron and ironware in the City of London. The company controlled not only the quality of goods, but also acted to increase trade opportunities for its members. It looked after fellow tradesmen in need, as well as their families, and especially widows and orphans. They set up an apprentice scheme and helped members buy businesses and their premises. And by 1328, they were involved in electing city officials. Eventually, they were granted a royal charter of incorporation by Edward IV in 1463.
This hall was built in 1925 after the third hall of the Ironmongers, which was in Fenchurch Street in the City of London, was bombed on the 7th of July 1917. That site was then sold, and the Ironmongers bought this site here near the City of London Museum and the Barbican, and they built this specifically purpose-built hall for the workings of the company.
Built in the Tudor style, this new hall proved to be a triumph of old-fashioned craftsmanship in the manner of the arts and crafts movement. It remains as a prime example of the design and craft skills of the 1920s. Sidney Tatchell, the architect, not only designed but personally supervised the building of this state-of-the-art livery hall, which was opened almost 100 years ago. It was designed for two specific purposes. Downstairs was the business centre of the company, while upstairs was designed for entertaining for ironmongers and their guests, the great and the good of the city. Today, almost 100 years on, it's still fit for purpose, used primarily in the same way.
Salamanders have become the mascots of the Ironmongers Company. It was thought in the old days that salamanders could survive the fires of a foundry. This, of course, we know they can't, but therefore they became the mascot of the company. This is St. Lawrence, a carving of St. Lawrence, who was martyred by the Romans, and he's become the patron saint of Ironmongery. So here we come into the drawing room. Having come up the grand staircase, onto the landing, into the drawing room, the place where people would gather before going into the banqueting hall.
The centrepiece of the hall is the original William Morris tapestry that lines the walls of this, the drawing room. The company bought its first hall in Fenchurch Street for £100 to be its home and headquarters. The hall was subsequently rebuilt and enlarged twice on that site before being damaged in an air raid in the First World War on the 7th of July 1917. They then decided to move here to Aldersgate.
Quite simple in design, but grand and designed to catch you by surprise from the flank. When you look up, you'll see the chandeliers. These chandeliers were saved from the bombing in the last hall in Fenchurch Street. Waterford crystal, beautiful examples. You see a large vaulted ceiling, specifically designed to give space and air. And the large dark holes you can see there are air vents for ventilation from times when people would smoke at meals and all the smoke used to go up through those portals. Today the hall is laid out for a lunch club. Because of COVID at the moment, we we can only afford to have four tables of six. The company silver, and at the end is the company buffet with examples of bits of plate from the company. As you go down the hall, on the right-hand side is the Lord Mayor's window. This company being one of the great 12 companies, in the olden days, if you wanted to be Lord Mayor of London, you had to be a member of one of the great 12. Nowadays, you can be a member of any company. This window, every time a Lord Mayor is elected into that high office, the company puts his coat of arms in the Lord Mayor's window. Around the edge of the hall, you'll see the coats of arms of the various masters of the company. Every master is elected by his peers from the court and serves 1 year appointment in his role as master. When he becomes master, his coat of arms are carved onto the wooden panels around the hall. And what you'll see here when you go around is various examples of families having been ironmongers, passing on to their children. And you'll see here masters from the same families. So let me take you through the hall, and we're going down here, purpose built, down into the business end of the hall. Down the long corridor, into the courtroom, which is where the board of directors sits. The clerk's office for the staff, and the court luncheon room, where people used to hold their court business meetings, and then they had a small kitchen and a room to be able to provide food for the court members when they're finished. So this here is a painting painted in the 1800s and exhibited at the Royal Academy in 1870, and it depicts the banqueting hall of the Ironmongers Hall in Fenchurch Street in London. Here you can see many of the same designs that were carried forward into the new banqueting hall. You'll see there are wooden panels on the side. On those panels are carved the coats of arms of the various masters who've been in the company. What is interesting, for example, you'll see the chandeliers. Those chandeliers have gaslight fittings on them. Those chandeliers survived the bomb and are now in the new hall. Also on the walls are the portraits and paintings. One of them is of the Viscount Hood, a painting by Gainsborough, who was the first honorary freeman of this company. And that painting now sits at the top of the landing as you go upstairs towards the drawing room and the banqueting hall. So this is a picture of the old Ironmongers Hall, which was standing in 1917 in Fenchurch Street in the City of London. On the 7th of July 1917, a German flying in a squadron of aircraft, Goethe aircraft, flew over the Channel and dropped bombs on the City of London. One of them landed in the courtyard of this hall. This is the courtroom of the Ironmongers Company, and here the court or the board of directors of this company sit and do their business. The chairman of the company, or the master as he's traditionally called, and two wardens sit at the top table.
Throughout the hall you will notice fine craftsmanship. The stone and wood carving is all done by individual craftsmen to the highest standards. The doors, the iron hinges and the latches were all handmade.
Look through and beyond the windows of this great courtroom, you'll see the Barbican Centre, a 1960s example of brutalistic architecture, and quite a contrast with this great arts and crafts Tudor design hall. Some of the glass in the hall was rescued from the original hall of Bonn.
We are delighted that we're now able to offer it for public hire, to individuals and businesses, for private and corporate events, dinners, lunches, weddings, board meetings and conferences. It is also a great location for filming.
Baby, I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars. Like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. I feel something so right. Doing the wrong thing. And I feel something so wrong. Doing the kills me, makes me feel alive. Yeah, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Yeah, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Watch it burn. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. And I feel something so wrong. We're doing the right thing. I could lie, could lie, could lie. Everything that drowns me makes me wanna fly. Yeah, I've been losing sleep.